So let's say I want to perform just a regular search for files on my Mac. Before I do, I want to show you that I've got this file here called List of Meteor Showers. It's a PDF. So great. So you know that it's there. Now I'm in a different Finder window at a different time and I want to search for it. So I'm going to type in Meteor. And I'm even going to select File Name Matches. And you can see nothing shows up. What's going on here? Why can't it find this file? It should be really easy for your Mac to find this file, but it doesn't show it. Well, there's several different things that could be wrong. The main thing is, and what is wrong here, and some of you may have already spotted it, is at the top here it says search and I can choose this Mac or projects. Now, before I did the search, I was looking in a folder called projects. So when I started the search, it started looking in the folder called projects. Turns out that file isn't in there. It's in another folder. So it didn't find it. Now I can easily solve this problem by switching from projects to this Mac. And now, sure enough, it finds this List of Meteor Showers and finds a few other files with the word meteor in them as well. So my main problem there was the scope. I had projects selected instead of this Mac. How can you prevent this? Well, if you always want to start your searches off searching your entire Mac, you can set a preference for that. If you go to Finder Preferences and you go to Advanced, there is an option here when performing a search, and you can say I want it to always search the current folder. I want to always just search this Mac, which will get you what you want. Also, you can say use the previous search scope. So wherever your last search was, it will search there. So you can set this up for search this Mac. And now it doesn't matter if I'm in this projects file and I search for Meteor. It will find that file even though I started out the search in the projects folder. The this Mac is selected rather than projects, the name of the folder. But what if that's not the problem? What if you're sure you're searching this Mac and you're still not finding a file you know is there? Well, the next thing to do is look at your Spotlight preferences. So go to System Preferences, go to Spotlight. And Spotlight is the system you're using to search your Mac. And then check your search results preferences here and make sure that folders and make sure that whatever file type it is you're looking for, like PDF documents or whatever it is selected. If it's not selected, it may not be indexing that type of file. So go through this carefully. For most of us, you're going to have everything here checked. Sometimes you uncheck things, like I don't want it to look in the developer tools for things, and I prefer to search mail inside the Mail app and not have those come up inside of Spotlight. But go and make sure that maybe you haven't turned off too many of these to make searches work. Also, look in Privacy. And Privacy is where you may have added a folder that you don't want search results to appear. For instance, say if you've got a directory of work files and there are thousands of files and they've got all sorts of different names and they're always showing up in your searches, but it's some old project you're not using anymore, you can use the plus button, add that folder, and then anything in that folder won't show up when you do a search. But sometimes people add things by accident in here, or maybe you added something for a temporary purpose and you forgot. So check in there to make sure that that isn't a problem. Now, what happens if you have all that and you're sure it's all right? You're sure that there's something wrong with the search function on your Mac? Well, there's something called a search index or a Spotlight index on your Mac that's an index of all your files. When you do a search, your Mac isn't actually looking at every file and comparing the results. That would take too long. Instead, what it does is it builds this quick index. It's like the index at the back of a book, right? You're searching for something in a book. You don't start looking at every word on every page for it. You go to the index and you look at it alphabetically. Well, Spotlight has an index like that. And if for some reason that index is messed up, you can force it to rebuild. The way to do that is you go in here, Privacy, and you add the entire, say your entire Documents folder, or better yet, even your entire Home folder. In this case, my Home folder is called MacMost. You add it, and then you simply remove it. Adding it removes all those results from the index, and then adding it back again means it will re-index that. Now, it doesn't happen instantly. It takes time. So it's not the kind of thing where you can do it and then expect the searches a few seconds later to have those entries in there. It may take several minutes or even hours, maybe even overnight if you have a massive hard drive filled with data files for it to do the index. But that is the official way that Apple wants you to rebuild your Spotlight index if you're having trouble. Apple has an official page of what to do if searches aren't working on your Mac. And they basically run through the things I just showed you. Another thing it shows you right at the top was make sure the text in the search field is what you want it to be. It could be very easy to have a little typo in there and then drive yourself crazy for the longest time trying to figure out why the search isn't working when maybe you're just one character off. And of course they list that first because I'm sure the percentage of error is greater than 0%. So you might want to just double check that, or just when in doubt, just retype the search term from scratch.